Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over an introduction to paint effects. And given that paint effects is a really robust, large sub-program inside of Maya, we'll see how far we can get. But mostly I want to give an introduction and how to get going and up and running with them, and also mention some of the powerful new features in Maya 2014. So let's get started. So I've created a plane here. And in order to start working with paint effects, you need to make an object paintable. So paint effects are located in the rendering tab, or hitting F6, and then you can go into the paint effects menu, make the object that you want to paint with paint effects paintable, then get a brush. And that will pull up the visor. And in addition to the visor, there's also a tab with, quite a few paint effects that you can also access in the visor. So I want to paint this with grasses. So I've already gone and selected grasses, and I'm going to choose grass carpet here. And the paint effects grass carpet is, the brush is just like most brush attributes in Maya, where you can hold down the B key and scrub to change the scale of the brush. In addition to that, the paint effects brush stroke follows, a lot of the paint effects attributes follow the brush stroke. And you can, there are additional modifiers inside of paint effects where you can modify how far they go. But you can see if I paint one stroke in this direction and one stroke in this direction, that the grass will follow the stroke by default. And a lot of the paint effects also have that attribute turned on. So in recognizing that, one of the things you might want to do in terms of designing your paint effects, if you're painting natural objects, is think about where your light source is. Given that there's a thing called phototropism with plants, they follow the sun, they bend toward the sun. I think most people have probably seen that. So in addition to that, one of the things in the past that was a little frustrating is that you had to like do multiple strokes. And there's a little bit more leeway now with a new feature inside of Maya 2014 where you can increase the brush profile width a little bit. You don't want to, I've found you get certain errors if you push it too much. But I'm making the brush width, almost twice as large or three times as large. And you can see that the paint effects are starting to go off the grid. And so there's a new feature inside of the, under tubes and creation, there's a surface snap attribute, and that brings all of the paint effects back onto the geometry that you've created. So by making the brush wider, you might want to go in and adjust or increase your paint effects density, the sample density. But if you make it too dense, you're certainly going to get a slowdown both on interactivity in Maya and then when you render. But if you know that the density needs to be high for your final render, you can dial down the display quality so that you know where your paint effects are, but then when you render, you will get a full, the density that you've asked for. And I found also that paint effects work well with underlying grass textures, if you're doing grass, for example, or grass and mud mixed. So we can also adjust the scale if you wanted to. So there's like a global scale attribute to your paint effects. So I'm going to turn up the display quality back to 100, and I'm going to turn down the sample density. All right, so one of the new, another new feature in Maya 2014 is the ability to have a make collide feature. So you can select the paint effects and select an object and then go into the paint effects menu and say make collide. So now you can see this object is colliding with the paint effects. Well, it seems like I must have selected the stroke. Yeah, okay. So I had selected the stroke. That was a little strange at first. One of the issues that I've noticed with scaling the brush too wide is that sometimes the paint effects will start jumping beyond the ground plane to the object. So that's a caveat for making your brush too wide. So in this case, yeah, I think I made my brush width 5. Maybe don't push it too far. Otherwise, you get this as an issue. But the Make Collide is a really great new feature. In addition to that, and so you can sort of interact with these paint effects a little bit. The one thing also, in terms of using this for animation, it doesn't quite work as an animation property, because the paint effects, unlike real grass, if you roll an object over it, you'll have some sort of compression, and then the grass will slowly come back up, whereas this is sort of snaps back into place. So in order to accomplish additional displacement, you might want to try something like the line modifier in paint effects. So under paint effects, there is a line modifier attribute. And the line modifier attribute is actually just under create modifier. And what comes up is a sphere, but you can change it into a cube if you want. And the default attributes are actually to make They actually make the paint effects, I think it's set to like scale. You can see that happening a little bit, the width scale is turned on. So as I roll this modifier over, you'll see the paint effects get scaled up somewhat. That's really overdoing it. Maybe I don't want it to be that much. But you can get some really interesting effects with this line modifier. One of the effects that I was using it for that I'll show in a different example is that I actually want to not even scale the paint effects, but there's other brush or occupy volume attributes. So you could actually have the paint effects fill this object. Under the brush tube attributes, you can apply forces with this brush. And so I think in combination with the collision attributes, you can create a nice feeling of your paint effects getting pushed aside by an object. So if you have a spherical object, you could sort of parent this line modifier to your, so you'd select the child first, which would be the line modifier, and then the parent, hit P. And so now when I move this object through the scene, you get some more additional, you get collision from this object, but you get an additional force attribute. That's pretty much it for a start. In the next video, I'm going to go over how to grow paint effects over time, how to animate some of the paint effects growth attributes. But this should be good for getting started with paint effects. Thanks so much for watching.